Hi everyone, this is Bronson, Zgeb, a content developer at Unity. In this Unite Now session, I'm going to show you how to capture profiler stats at runtime using Unity's new Runtime Profiler API. This was added in Unity 2020.2, and it allows you to capture profiler stats in the editor in development builds, but also in release builds and on device. So let's get started. I'm just going to jump right into my project. And you can see I already have some profiler stats set up here in the top left corner, but I noticed I was having some performance issues on my phone, and I think it might be related to draw calls. So I'm going to add another line here to track my draw calls count. So in order to start, I'm actually going to start with a clean slate here. So this is a profiler controller, and its job is going to be to record the profiler stats and then display them to the screen. So I'm going to come over to the Profiler Recorder documentation page. And they have a nice little example script. And I'm just going to copy that directly into my profiler controller. There's one little issue here. In the example script, they use unsafe code to save on managed memory allocations. You can do that, and if you're comfortable with unsafe code, I recommend you do that, but I just want to make it a little bit simpler, so I'm just going to use a list instead. So this is one other thing. In the example script, they use onGUI to display the stats. Unfortunately, I don't think you're going to be able to read this very well in the video, so I'm going to display the stats on a canvas. So I'm just going to create a TextMesh Pro text area. Let's delete the onGUI code. And I just got to make sure to hook up the text area and then hit play. There we go. So next, I wanted to show the draw calls. So I'm going to create a new profiler recorder. And that's going to record the draw calls. On enable, we initialize the profiler recorder. Here, you tell it which profiler category the stat you're looking for is part of, and then the name of the stat. In our case, that's draw calls count. On disable, we always want to dispose of our recorders when we're done with them. And then we're going to add a line on update to display the draw calls. So here we had some extra math. This just converts a value from bytes into megabytes to make it nicer to display. In our case, we're getting a count back, not bytes, so we don't need that. So the two values above, those are bytes. And then the top value here is actually in nanoseconds. So we have some extra formatting just to convert from nanoseconds into milliseconds. And here you see the draw calls are being displayed. So let me just recap what we did here. We create a new profiler recorder, the draw calls count recorder. On enable, we initialize the profiler recorder. We tell it which stat to track. On disable, always dispose of your recorders when you're done with them. And in update, we added a line to our display string that just outputs the draw calls count. So you're probably wondering though, how did I know what to put in here? So for that, we're gonna go to the documentation page. And up here, for a list of built-in profiler markers, you can see the documentation pages on the memory profiler, rendering profiler, virtual texturing profiler. So draw calls is going to be part of the rendering profiler. If we go down here, see that there's a nice table of all the available stats with their name, a description of the stat, and finally, if they're available in the release player or not. So I'd mentioned earlier, this API works in release builds as well as development builds or in the editor, but not all the stats are available in release. And that's why we have this extra column here to tell you whether or not this particular set would be available in release or not. So just so you know, I picked draw calls as my example, but there are a lot of other useful stats available here, such as the set pass calls, the triangles count, and the vertex count. And these are all available in the release player. So next up, I'm worried that my player character takes too long to update, so I wanted to add another stat to track that. So I'm going to create a new profiler recorder, and that's going to track how long it takes for me to update my player. So since my player character update isn't built in, it's something I wrote, what can I pass into my start new to let it know which block of code I'm profiling? Well, for that, we can actually create a new profiler marker. So when you create a profiler marker, you have to give it a name. You can call it whatever you want, but it's a good idea to be descriptive. So I'm just going to call mine player.update. And now in my game, I have a game manager that calls update on my player. So that makes it really easy to wrap my update player with my new marker. So this is basically, it's just like a stopwatch. I'm just saying start timing here and stop timing here and tell me how long it took to get from here to here. So in between, we're updating the player. So start timing, update the player, stop timing, tell me how long that took. With that, I can now just pass my marker directly into my start new and that'll work. Always make sure to dispose of your recorders when you're done with them. And then we just need one more line to our display string. Except in this case, we're getting back nanoseconds. So I'm just going to copy the line from frame time that converts a value from nanoseconds into milliseconds. And I'm going to put that in here. Just got to make sure to pass in the right recorder. So you probably noticed we're using a function getRecorderFrameAverage that's available up here. All this is doing is getting an average of the past bunch of frames that we've already recorded and then using that value instead and then converting it to milliseconds and showing that. And the reason why we do that is just because the raw nanosecond value from frame to frame is going to be too wild. So it's not that easy to look at, basically, to display. And there you go. Now we can see our update player is taking 0.1, somewhere between 0.1 and 0.2 milliseconds. You may not even see that it's stuttering in the video. And just for the sake of completion, I'm going to make a non-development build, a release build, and show you that this still works. So you go. I'm in a release build. I can see the draw calls. I can see the other stats that we got from the example script. And I can see that my update player actually takes very little time at all in a release build. So that's great. So I'm just going to go back to the documentation real quick. And I just want to show, so the main meat of the new API is in this profiler recorder. And this is what's going to do the recording, and you can grab the values and display it. And then to know what you can actually track, we can go to the different module pages, like rendering profile, et cetera. And also, if you really want a full exhaustive list of all the available metrics, you can go to this profiler recorder handle.getAvailable. And here we have another example script. And what this does is it actually enumerates through every single metric that's available and then outputs that. And I did that earlier, and I just output it to a file so we could take a look. So here's the file where I output all the available stats. So each line in this file represents a profiler recorder handle, which a profiler recorder could hook into and then gather metrics from. And there are a lot of stats available here. So if you ever wanted to know, I don't know, let's say how many audio clips do I have in memory? There's a handle for that. Or how many bytes are the audio clips taking in memory? There's a handle for that. If you wanted to say, look at how long each particle system module was taking per frame, there is a handle for each individual module there. I made this list while I was running in the editor, so there are quite a few stats available. Remember, when you make a development build or a release build, there aren't going to be as many stats there. So I encourage you to try it out for yourself to see what's available. And by the way, if you try to hook into a stat that isn't available, you're not going to get an error. It's not going to crash. The profiler recorder just isn't going to return anything. So if you want to check if a stat is available in the current configuration, you can use profilerrecorder.valid to make sure that it's connected to a valid state. And if not, you could just remove it from your display. So before I go, I just wanted to leave you with some helpful resources. There are links to the documentation pages that we looked at in this talk, as well as the example scripts that we wrote in this talk. So thanks for watching my Unite Now session. I hope you learned something. And I just want to encourage you to check out unity.com/unitenow for other inspiring Unite Now sessions.